After Mueller seeks interview with POTUS, Trump drops shocking truth bomb on his head. Special Counsel Robert Mueller is seeking an interview with President Donald Trump, and Democrats are screaming that he'll be subpoenaed if he refuses to go. Of course, Mueller is leading the bogus Trump-Russia investigation, and his back is up against the wall as it is starting to fall apart. Trump has answered by dropping a shocking truth bomb right on Mueller's head, and it's rocking Capitol Hill as the biggest win by any president in the last 100 years. The biggest political scandal is about to be completely exposed, and it's going to make Watergate look like a picnic on a Sunday afternoon. While the Democrats continue to grasp at lies and bogus conspiracy theories, we now know what the president has known all along, he just couldn't reveal it until now. Before we get to the truth, backed up by facts, on what in the world was going on at the FBI and DOJ regarding the so-called Russian collusion, let's just say Trump has no reason to not go and speak with Mueller. He wants to go speak to Mueller because the president has been running his own sting operation for the last year, and now, he has all the intelligence he needs to squash these traitors like the cockroaches they truly are. There is a cabal of traitors who conspired starting in July 2016 to prevent Trump from becoming president. Sometime around November 2016, the one good guy left in former President Barack Obama's administration and in charge of a major intel agency, the director of the National Security Administration Admiral Mike Rogers, found proof that a cabal at the FBI and DOJ were spying on then-candidate Donald Trump. We know this from FBI agent Peter Strzok's text, which confirms the insurance policy in case Trump is elected. What Rogers did was notify Trump, going over the heads of Obama's men, Director of National Intelligence James Clapper and CIA Director John Brennan. We know Rogers went to Trump Tower on December 30th, and the next day, Trump's presidential transition team moved immediately to Bedminster, New Jersey. Recall the sheer outrage by the Democrats and mainstream media when Trump dropped his tweet in March 2017, claiming his phones were tapped by Obama. The Democrats called Trump a crazy conspiracy theory nut. They called him a liar, saying how dare he accuse Obama and his minions of a crime. Rush Limbaugh went over this on his January 8, 2018, broadcast, saying, "The director of the NSA is Admiral Mike Rogers. And, in I think November, December, I'm not sure which, Mike Rogers visited Trump in Trump Tower. We don't know what was said. But, he's military, and it's kind of unusual for a military man, even though he is the head of the NSA, to jump chain, but he went and talked to Trump." Limbaugh continued, "And shortly after Mike Rogers spoke to Trump, Trump relocated his transition team out of Trump Tower and over to his golf club in Bedminster, New Jersey." Now, it is assumed by people who have been studying this that Trump was alerted, and then, of course, Trump tweeted a couple months later in March about how unfair it was that Trump Tower had been wiretapped. What Rogers knew is what Devin Nunes was shocked to learn when he viewed highly classified documents that can only be viewed in a special room called a Sensitive Compartmented Information Facility, or SIF. If you'll recall, this led Nunes to run over to the White House and divulge information to Trump. Then, he called a press conference. Again, Nunes could not reveal to the public exactly what he saw, but we can now confirm what caused Nunes to almost have a nervous breakdown. According to the conservative Treehouse, after Nunes reviewed the information on March 22, 2017, he stated the intelligence product was not related to Russia, or the FBI Russian counterintelligence investigation. The report adds, House Intelligence Committee Chairman, Devin Nunes, then held a brief press conference and stated he has been provided intelligence reports brought to him by unnamed sources that include significant information about President-elect Trump and his transition team. Here's exactly what went on. As you all know, neither Trump nor anyone on Trump's campaign ever colluded with Russia. It was a fabricated scheme that was started by a cabal including former FBI Director James Comey and former Attorney General Loretta Lynch, and it goes all the way to the top, Barack Obama. This group used a false document that the Hillary Clinton campaign paid for, which has become known as the Russian dossier, as evidence to obtain FISA warrants to spy on Trump and his campaign. This is what Admiral Mike Rogers found out about, and he immediately started an investigation into the bogus FISA warrants. But, there's more. The conservative treehouse has uncovered the proof that Obama indeed knew about this cabal and sanctioned it. Sure, we always knew Obama was in on illegal schemes, but proving it is another thing. An example of an intelligence product created for the executive branch, it would be the President's Daily Briefing or PDB, further reported the conservative treehouse, adding, our research indicates that in February and March 2017 Chairman Devin Nunes, a Gang of Eight member, reviewed intelligence reports, most likely PDBs, that were assembled exclusively for the office of the former president, Obama. That is why he went to the Eisenhower Executive Office Building, EOB, information facility to review. So, here's the kicker, what Nunes was looking at in the SIF was Obama's PDBs, meaning Nunes read the reports Obama was getting as president by the cabal about spying on Trump. If it was not for Admiral Mike Rogers and Representative Devin Nunes, who knows where this country would be today? In essence, and I cannot stress this enough, they averted a constitutional crisis. Now, my fellow Americans, get ready for this entire scheme to be outed by Trump's sting operation on January 15, 2018. Save that date, pop some popcorn, sit back, and watch the sheer panic and gnashing of teeth by the Democrats and their useful idiot supporters. Inspector General Michael Horowitz is the lead investigator of Trump's counter-intel operation into these crimes, and he's announced that his findings will be released to the public on January 15. Watch the deep state rats as they are rounded up and made to answer for crimes that rise to the level of treason.